Today, I'm going to show you how to get record count in a pivot table. To give an example, if we have this little data set, if we try to use a pivot table on it, so if I go ahead and go to insert and do a pivot table, we're going to grab the data as is, that's fine, create. And then I'll go under values, maybe we'll do sales and sum them up. And maybe under rows, I'll do sales rep. So you can see the results I get is that the ones that didn't have any sales rep assigned here, which would be apparently just this one, that's the total for that. And then we're going to get the total for each. Now, usually if I wanted to get number of sales instead of getting sum of sales, I could just simply switch this function from sum to counter. And that would count the number of sales. The problem of this is that this is not really number of records. This is number of cells that are not blank. So right now, if you look at this grand total, this says 16. But if I go to my data over here and look here, see we have 20 rows here. The first one is headers. So we're looking at 19 records total. And if we go to our pivot table, our grand total is 16. And the reason for that is because counter function does not count blanks. So it doesn't count this, it doesn't count this, it doesn't count this as a record. Now, one way to go around this, if you have a column you can trust in your data that will never have blanks in it, you could use that column and count it. But in this particular instance, every and each column I got has some blanks someplace. So I could not do that. This is why if I wanted to get the number of records, what I would do, I would go back here, and instead of doing this, I'm going to remove this value from here, and I'm going to add my own value, only this time I'm going to use calculated field. And here, as my function, I'm going to delete that zero and use a function rows. Make sure you do that S, don't use just row, rows. And then we follow that by the column that we want to use. Really doesn't matter which column you use from your data. In this case, I'll choose the sales column. So I'll just do sales, close parentheses, just like that. And finally, the last thing here is we want to make sure we switch this from sum to custom function. And if I do this, now I should have my counts. And you can see I got 19 as the total count, which was the actual count of records. So if you remember, 20 lines, first one is the header, so we got 19 records. And now if we look, for example, at Jake, there is one here, there's another one here, that's two. And doesn't look like there's any others. So if we go back and take a look, Jake, the count is two. So at this point, we can just rename this field from a calculated field to something like record count. And that should get us what we're actually after. That's how you get the actual number of rows in your pivot tables. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.